Hello fellow makers, welcome to HyperMakes, and in this video I will show you how you can make your DIY wireless RGB light stick. For making this project you will require these items. First, take your LED baton and disassemble it. Normally it consists of two end caps and LED controller circuit, and be careful to check the capacitors because they may still hold charge and shock you if you had tested the LED baton before buying it. Keep aside the controller circuit as we don't need it anymore. You may need it in any future project. Now take your LED baton and try to remove slowly the previous LED strip that has been mounted in it. You can keep it if you want to use it, or you can just discard it as we are going to use a NeoPixel strip. Now take the NeoPixel LED strip and cut it to the size of the stock LED strip, and count down the number of LEDs in the NeoPixel strip, as we will need it later for programming it. Prepare the end caps by cutting a small hole or a rectangular outlet on one of the end caps so that it can be used for passing the wires for NeoPixel strip outside the baton. I have also trimmed off the notches of this GST connector so that it is easy to fade in or fade out of the outlet. Finally, use your hot glue gun and add a dab of hot glue at both the ends of the strip for secure mount. Also, one thing I did not check while buying my baton is that it should have a removable diffuser, as you can see, because sometimes it is very difficult to put in the NeoPixel strip and glue it to the place. Now for making the controller, first take your perforated PCB and start placing the components on it. Start with the node MCU first, then the USB micro breakout, and then the 3-pin male header. If your PCB is a little big, like in my case, then we need to cut it to a desired size. Take a permanent marker or any marker and mark the side which we need to cut. Remember to mark on the both sides of PCB, or you may break it while snapping in the next step. For cutting it to the desired size, take your PCB and take a straight edge like this steel scale and put it on the mark. Now take your hobby knife and score on both sides by using the blunt side of your knife, not the sharp side. As you can see, I'm going it right here, it is wrong. Then after scoring a line on both sides, take a straight edge and snap the PCB in two pieces. The USB micro breakout board comes with its own metal header pins. So prepare and heat your soldering iron and start soldering the pins to the breakout board. We are going to use only the VCC and ground pins of the breakout board, but still we need to solder all pins, as it will provide more mechanical strength to the USB port because it will be prone to repeated stress when plugging in and out. Follow the wiring schematic as shown here for doing all the connections, and also you can see this layout for your reference. I have used thin enameled copper wire for all the connections. It is my personal preference as it keeps the project wiring clean, and I recommend using flux core solder wire as it results in better clean solder joints. After doing all the connections, this is how your microcontroller should look like or similar to that. You can use any method to mount your controller to the battle, but this is my method. Take your electric drill and a 2mm drill bit and drill on both sides according to the length of the PCB. Then take your zip ties and push them through the holes in the PCB and do it for both holes. After that, push the zip ties through the holes in the LED pattern and lock and tighten them in the place. Also check the orientation of the controller before tightening all the zip ties. Finish the construction of LED pattern by clipping off the extra length of zip ties. Connect your Node MCU to the computer and check for the COM port in the device manager. After that, go to WLED GitHub page and click on this latest button. It will take you to the latest releases of this software, and then you can download your ESP8266 bin file. Go back to the home page and scroll down until you find the quick start guide section, then click on this wiki button. Scroll down and go to this link over here and click on it. Then go to the ESP Home Flasher Tool latest releases page and download the ESP Home Flasher Tool for your computer. You can use for 64-bit or 32-bit, so mine is 64-bit, so I can download it. Open your ESP Home Flasher exe.dot file and select your COM port. If it is not available, then press the refresh button. After that, you can select your COM port. Then click on this browse button. Then browse through the bin file that you downloaded and click on it. Then click on flash ESP button to flash the firmware. After completion, just close the ESP Home Flasher tool, but do not disconnect the mNode MCU from the computer. You can power the controller using a micro USB cable and connecting it to a phone charger. But you can also use a small power bank or a 18650 battery power bank like this one to power the microcontroller. On startup, the lights should turn orange and it is ready to be configured using a mobile device like a smartphone or a tablet or even a computer. Turn on the Wi-Fi of your device and search for available networks. Select WLED AP from the available networks. Open your web browser and type the following address in the address bar. The home address for the web page of the controls is 4.3.2.1. So type it and click enter. The welcome page of WLED should load up and you will be presented with two options. We need to set up the local Wi-Fi settings as we will be using it in AP mode. But you can set it up if you are going to use it for just ambient lighting. Click on to the controls button and it should take you to the controls of the light stick. Then you can browse through different colors and effects from the respective colors and effects tab. It is situated down in the site as you can see. Click on the effects tab, then you can browse through different effects that you can use for your light stick. It has several effects like solid, aurora, blink and even fade. I will show you one by one how the light effects work. And if you are ever stuck on a step or want more information, then you can check out this Instructables post that I have linked in the description. It has more details in every step and more high quality pictures. Hope you liked this video and learned something. And if you like my content, then why not consider subscribing? It is free and you can back out whenever you want. So thanks for watching, stay safe and wear masks.